That must be Tim. Hello? Tim?
Oh, Jane? Hey, it's Stu. Is Tim there? He hasn't been answering his cell.
Oh. Oh, hello, Stu. No, Tim's not here. He left early today. Something came up and he rushed out. He said he'd call me when he was done. But he hasn't called yet. He must be really busy.
What? Really? It's Songkran Day and he's still working? I thought you two made plans to spend your Songkran at Chiang Mai.
We were supposed to. We packed last night and everything, but then this thing came up, and you know Tim, he's all about his job these days. He said he'd be quick. I don't think we can make it now, but whatever. What did you want to talk to him about?
Oh, nothing really. I was going to ask you guys to buy me some stuff from Chiang Mai, but I guess you're not going anywhere for the holidays then, huh?
I guess not. Well, I'll keep myself busy, though. I've been meaning to do some gardening in the yard. Maybe it's the time.
Well, that sounds fun. And I wouldn't worry about Tim too much. He just got promoted, and he's very excited about it. As for me, I'm not doing anything over the holiday either. So, hey, if you need a hand with your gardening, I'm just a call away.
Oh, I'll be fine. I wouldn't want to bother you.
It wouldn't be a bother. That's what friends are for. Anyway, I better get going. I'll talk to you soon, though.
Okay, thanks, Stu. Bye.
Bye.
And now we're catching up on traffic accidents. Unfortunately, the number of traffic accidents during this year's Songkran Festival is not less than last year's. Despite police using drink drive charge as a preventive measure, 53,542 arrests have been reported. The greatest cause of accidents is motorcycles, then public transportation and personal vehicles, respectively. Over 37,000 charges have been filed and more than 900 vehicles have been impounded. There are already 603 accidents reported today.
Hello?
Just a nightmare. It's so real. My head. Everything's spinning. One more drink couldn't hurt, right?
Spread through crowds today when a solar eclipse took place without any official announcement from scientists or astronomers. Latest figures show that the phenomenon began at 10 a.m. when the moon began its transit across the sun. The eclipse will be complete at 12 p.m. Then it will leave sight by 2 p.m. This year's eclipse will persist for as long as the one that occurred in 2002. Meanwhile, Royal Thai Police Commissioner General Prayut Chan-ra has ordered that all areas be secured by officers who will also be directing traffic as traffic jams are likely with citizens coming out to witness the phenomenon. This will allow for local vendors to pitch their stall. Eclipse sunglasses are now the most sought-after items during this event. Experts urge you to avoid using normal sunglasses or looking directly at the sun, as it can perilously damage your eyes and could lead to blindness. Sunglasses or films made specifically for this phenomenon are highly recommended. The Astrology Association of Thailand, on the other hand, predicts that the changing of the moon is an ominous event that could lead to chaos and violence.
Hey, Tim. I've been trying to reach you, man. Did you turn off your phone? Your colleagues, they're worried about you. And so am I. You really need to take it easy with the drinks. You aren't young anymore. Look, man, I'm here if you need a talk. We all want you to be yourself again. We're rooting for you.
What the hell?
It's getting worse.
Get here. Damn, it's dark. I can't see a thing. Reminds me of the place Jane mentioned in her diary. No. Where am I? Done this.
This is local radio news out of Gangoy, Sudbury, reporting live on September 4th, 1959. The strange happenings of Bontime Village persist and are still observed by frightened local residents. Villagers reporting hear livestock screaming during the night and find the bodies of the slain animals in the morning. Clear laundry hung out to dry overnight appears in the morning to be filthy and covered in blood stains. Mysterious lights roam the distant darkness as if it were alive. The people of the town are terrified and lock themselves in their house as soon as the sun sets. Some of the villagers have even assembled crude fences made from the branches of a monkey apple tree, believing a superstition that such a fence around their home will protect them from the something that is behind these mysterious occurrences. Local needs to determine the cause of these happenings and comfort the local populace.